Assalamu alaikum dear students, aaj ki is video mein hum FPSC lecturer BS 17 PPSC NTS aur dusre jitne bhi teaching related exams hain unke hawale se hum important MCQs ko discuss karenge. In videos mein hum professional part ko jo education section hota hai isko hum discuss karenge. Aaj ki is video mein hum knowledge of Bloom's taxonomy ko discuss karenge aur coming videos ke andar hum teaching techniques and methodology, classroom management and discipline aur testing evaluation ke hawale se discuss karenge. Shuru karte hain aaj ke is video mein hum Bloom's taxonomy ke hawale se jitne bhi important MCQs hain inko hum discuss karenge. First question hai, the classification of cognitive domain was presented by which of the following scientists? You have four options, guess which one is right. The right answer is Benjamin S. Bloom's. The focus of Bloom's taxonomy is on, again you have four options. The right option is educational objectives. Taxonomy of educational objective was presented in 1947, 56, 54 or 58. The right answer is 1956. Bloom's taxonomy is a set of learning domains. Kitne learning domains hai? Isme again you have four options. The right option is 3. Bloom's taxonomy is a set of 3 learning domains. The first one is cognitive, second is affective, and third one is psychomotor domain. The cognitive domain involves knowledge, manner, physical movement, or learning. Cognitive domain jo involve hota hai, usme knowledge hota hai. The affective domain involves knowledge, manner, physical movement, or learning. So isme aayega right option manner. Psychomotor domain involved knowledge, manner, physical movement or learning. Right option is physical movement. The simplest skill in cognitive domains of Bloom's taxonomy is remembering, understanding, evaluating or synthesizing. The right option is remembering. Remembering jo hai cognitive domain ka simplest skill. The most complex skill in cognitive domain of Bloom's taxonomy is remembering, understanding, evaluating or synthesizing. The right option is evaluating. The most complex skill of Bloom's taxonomy is remembering. Again you have four options, guess which one is right. Remembering, understanding, evaluating or originating. The right answer is originating. To break information into parts and to examine the information is called, again you have four options. The right option is analyzing. To compile the information into pattern and propose a plan is called, again you have four options. The right option is synthesizing. What is the highest level of cognitive domain? Cognitive domain ka jo highest level hai wo kaun sa hai? Right option aapke paas hai evaluation. Dear students, yahan pe ek baat aapne yaad rakhni hai aur is tarah ke bhi aur MCQs aa sakte hai jis tarah ye Bloom's taxonomy ka initial ya original model hai jisko 1956 mein Benjamin S. Bloom's ne present kiya tha. और बाद में 2001 में इसको जो है रिवाइज करके इसमें चेंजेस किए गए हैं. द मैकेनिज्म टू डिटरमाइन द वर्थ ऑफ अ थिंग इज कॉल्ड असेसमेंट, मेजरमेंट, एवैल्यूएशन और नन. राइट ऑप्शन इज एवैल्यूएशन. नोइंग, मेमोराइजिंग एंड रिकॉलिंग इज कंसर्न विथ कॉम्प्रिहेंशन, नॉलेज, एप्लीकेशन और नन. ऑफकोर्स knowing, memorizing and recalling is concerned with knowledge. Cognitive domain has how many subgroups? Cognitive domains ke kitne subgroups hain? Cognitive domain ke 6 subgroups hain. Aap yahan pe dekh sakte jo cognitive domain hai uske 6 subgroups hain. ये इसका इनिशियल मॉडल है, मैंने पहले भी लिखा है और ये इसका रिवाइज मॉडल है. रिवाइज और इनिशियल मॉडल दोनों में इसके सब ग्रुप्स जो है छह हैं। द बॉटम मोस्ट लेवल ऑफ लर्निंग इन कॉग्निटिव डोमेन इज कॉल्ड अंडरस्टैंडिंग एप्लीकेशन कंप्रिहेंशन और नॉलेज। सो द राइट ऑप्शन इज नॉलेज। टू ग्रेप द मीनिंग ऑफ द मटीरियल इज कॉल्ड अंडरस्टैंडिंग एप्लीकेशन कंप्रिहेंशन और नॉलेज। Right option is comprehension. To break down material into modules to identify its organizational structure is, again, you have four options. The right option is analysis. To put ideas together to form a new whole is called, again, you have four options. The right option is evaluation. Which domain is concerned with the physical movement and practice of the motor skill areas? Again, you have four options. The right answer is psychomotor domain. So, psychomotor domain is concerned with the physical movement and practice of the motor skill areas. What is the focus of cognitive domain? Cognitive domain ka focus kya hai? Again, you have four options. Intellectual skills. Affective domain divided into how many subgroups? जिस तरह मैंने पूछा कि cognitive domain में कितने subgroups होते हैं, इसी तरह जो second set है इसमें affective domain इसके कितने subgroups हैं? Again you have four options, guess करें। Five. Affective जो domain है उसके subgroups पांच हैं और first हमने discuss किया था cognitive जिसमें छह उसके subgroups हैं और affective में पांच groups हैं subgroups। आप देख सकते हैं पांच जो है subgroups हैं, जिस तरह cognitive domain के छह subgroups हैं इसी तरह affective domain के पांच subgroups हैं। Characterization जो है first है highest level है और lowest जो है वो receiving है। Which of the following is the lowest level of learning in the affective domain? अभी हमने बताया था कि affective domain में जो lowest level है वो कौन सा है? आपके पास है attending या receiving। Attending या receiving जो है आपके पास lowest में आता है, ठीक है। Highest जो है वो आपके पास characterization है और जो लोवेस्ट है वो अटेंडिंग और रिसीविंग है। विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कैन बी प्लेस्ड एट द हाईएस्ट लेवल ऑफ लर्निंग इन अफेक्टिव डोमेन? अफेक्टिव डोमेन में कौन सा हाईएस्ट है? कैरेक्टराइजेशन डी इज द राइट ऑप्शन। कमिटमेंट टू अटेन टू अ पर्टिकुलर फेनोमेना कैन बी कंसिडर्ड एज, अगेन यू हैव फोर ऑप्शंस। द राइट ऑप्शन इज अटेंडिंग और रिसीविंग।